Hello friends, today I'm going to show you the new plants which are very common in indoor plant market, but I don't have these plants. All these plants are very cheap and also need very less care. All these plants are great in terms of foliage as well as they are recommended by NASA as air purifying plants. I purchased some aglaonemas, philodendrons, ferns and calatheas. So, the first plant, as you can see, is a variety of aglaonema. You can see the leaves are totally in silver shade with a tinge or a little of green. The leaves are quite thick and you can see there is some new growth in this plant. This plant cost me around 50 rupees. You can see in cost of one plant, I got 2 to 3 new plant babies. The plant is very healthy. But you can see the older leaves are quite in bad shape, but the new leaves are very good in shade. All you know that aglaonemas are also referred as Chinese evergreen. These plants are native to China and Philippines. These plants are very well known for its leafy foliage and these are very easy to care house plant. This plant belongs to Erica family. So the next plant, as you can see, the next plant is another variety of aglaonema. This variety is known as aglaonema silver queen. You can see the leaves are very lushy but very narrow in comparison of the previous one. Aglaonemas are very well known for its foliage and, as I told you, very well known for its air purifying qualities. This plant seems to remove formaldehyde, xylene, toluene and another airborne toxins. And you can see in price of one plant, this plant cost me around 70 rupees and you can see in price of one plant, I got 5 to 6 new plant babies. All the varieties of aglaonema prefers low to moderate indirect sunlight. They are very easy to care but they need very well drained soil with lot of perlite. I don't have perlite this time, so I mixed sand with my soil mixture. There are more than 21 to 25 varieties of aglaonema. So the next plant is also a variety of aglaonema. This plant is known as aglaonema crispum. The leaves are quite big in size and quite thick also. The leaf is also in green and silver shades. You can see the plant is quite huge in size. This plant cost me around 40 rupees. You can see in the middle section, the new leaf is popping out. I hope that in 1 to 2 weeks, the new leaves will come out. So moving towards another plant, you can see this is a variety of philodendron. This variety is known as Rojo Congo. You can see the leaves are quite huge and quite thick and the stems are in burgundy color. And in the middle section, the new leaf is just coming out. All the philodendrons are very easy to care also. They need or they love bright but indirect sunlight for their better growth. So moving towards our other plant, as you can see, these two are the varieties of fern. These plants are best for hanging baskets. I will do it later when it will grow in size. This plant likes its soil to be damp but not soggy soil and its soil must be rich in nutrients. These are very drought tolerant plant also. The fern will thrive in humid condition. You can grow it as indoor plant, but also you can keep all this plant in outdoor, but in that condition you have to put your plant in partial shade to full shaded area. You can see that there are very new growth is coming out. According to NASA Air Clean study, ferns are very effective at removing common household toxins like formaldehyde, xylene and toluene. So the variety you can see, this plant is known as Boston fern. This is a very easy and very low maintenance fern. So the first variety is known as tiger fern, or the scientific name is Nephrolepis exaltata. You can see there is very beautiful variegation, and some of the leaves are totally in yellow color. I really love the variegation. The plant is very huge in size also. This plant cost me around 50 rupees. Very easy to care, but they need high humidity, so you need to mist your plant time to time to keep up the humidity up. So the next plant you can see is Calathea zabrina. Calathea zabrina belongs to Marantaceae or prayer plant family. This specific variety is native to South Brazil. This plant recently got new taxonomic classification, and now it is considered as Gopertia zabrina. These plants are very high maintenance plant and they love high humidity. So you need to mist your plant time to time to keep up the humidity, and you need to get a very good soil mixture for this plant. And for keep up the humidity, you can also put a pebble tray under the plant. I just mist my plant 3 to 4 times in a day with filtered water. This plant belongs to tropical forest. So if this plant get low humidity, then you can see some browning tips. So you need to keep up the humidity all the time for its better growth. That's all for today. See you in my next video.